we will discuss about exercise 2.1, page number 32. These questions are located in page number 32. Now our first question is, find the degree of each of the polynomials given below. So we should find the degree of each of the polynomials. Already you know very well how to find the degree. So the first question here, total how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3. Three terms are given. Why? Because it is dependent, the terms are dependent by plus symbol or minus symbol. So here two symbols are there. Two symbols means the polynomial we are getting three terms. So how to find the degree? Just we should take the highest degree of each term. Here the degree is 5, here the degree is 4, there is no variable, so degree is 0. Which is the highest degree? 5 is the highest degree, so degree is equal to 5. At the same time, we should find the all. For example, second, 2, there is no value, 1, there is no variable, 0. 2, 1, 0, which is the highest one? 2, so degree is equal to 2. Coming to the third one, what is the degree of that polynomial? This is also one of the polynomial, constant polynomial. But how we can find the degree here? There is no variable. No variable means the degree is equal to 0. Same like that, we have to do the remaining. Now coming to the second question. Which of the following expressions are polynomials? Which of the following expressions are polynomials in one variable? One variable means the expression consists only one variable. Either the expression totally it has with x, or it has with p, or it has with q. So we have to find that which expressions are polynomials with only one variable. One variable means either both total quotient are with only one variable, or which are not. Give the reason. So first quotient, 3x square minus 2x 5. So observe here, in this problem just we have only one variable, that is x. So one variable. Now coming to it, is not polynomial or not. What is the definition of polynomial? Polynomial means the variables are involved, the given variables in the expression involved only non-negative integers of the power. The powers, the exponent of the given variables are non-negative integers. So those are called polynomials, otherwise it is not a polynomial. Non-negative integer means the exponents is 0 or positive numbers. If it has minus values, it is not a polynomial. If here we have rational number, means fractional numbers, not polynomial. Root, not polynomial. If the variable, it is in the denominator place also, it is not a variable. Not a polynomial. So coming to the first question, x with one variable. Observe the power, x have 2. Here also x have 1. There is no x. 0. So it is a polynomial with one variable. Now second question. Single variable is there. X only. Observe the power 2. Is it also a polynomial with one variable? Coming to the third one. Total how many variables are given? Let us see here. We have two variables, one is p, another one is q. So total it has two variables. So it is not a polynomial with one variable. Now here it is also not a polynomial. Why? Because in the second term the variable y in the denominator place. Since the variable, the second term contains the variable in denominator, so it is not a polynomial. Here also, it is also not a polynomial because the first term's exponent, the first term exponent is fraction number. It is not an integer. Why? Because root x can be written as x to the power of 1 by 2. So we are getting here fraction number, so that is also not a polynomial. It is also not a polynomial because of it has two variables x and y, so it is also not a polynomial in one variable. Just you have to write like that. Now, write the coefficient of the x cube. Just to be sure, identify the x cube coefficient in each of the following. First of all, where is the x cube located here? First one. Where we have to find the coefficient in front of the x cube? In front of the x cube, there is no value. So, we should write 1. So, coefficient of x cube is 1. In the second one, where is the x cube located here? In here. In front of the value is 1. But observe the sign also. Minus 1. Coming to here, x cube. Coefficient is root 2. X cube coefficient is 2. Like that you have to follow everything. Here, observe here, there is no x cube term. So, the coefficient, there is no x cube, so the coefficient is 0. There is no x cube, so the coefficient is equals to how much? You only find out that answer. Okay, now going to the fourth bit. Let's start the fourth bit. Classify the following as linear, quadratic, cube polynomial. So, according to the number of terms, we have to divide the polynomials like this. So, which one has linear, which one has quadratic, which one has cubic polynomial, depending on the number of terms. First one, here how many symbol, how many signs are given? Two signs. One is plus, one is minus. So, these two term signs are divided that given expression into three terms. One, two, three. So, total how many? Sorry. So, to find the which one it is linear or quadratic or cubic dependent on the number degree of the given polynomial. Here, what is the degree of the first term? 2. What is the degree of the second term? 1. What is the degree of the third term? There is no variable, means degree is 0. So, highest degree is 2. So, if the degree is 2, that polynomial is called as quadratic polynomial. It is the quadratic polynomial because the degree is 2. Next, here what is the degree of this one? Here the degree is 1, here the degree is 3, highest is 3. So that hence it is called as cubic polynomial. Just we have identified the degree of the each term, take the highest value. 2, 1, 0. So highest one is 2. It is also quadratic. X minus 1, degree is 1. So, the degree, if the degree is 1, hence it is called as a linear polynomial. Like that you have to find the remaining 2. Now, coming to the fifth bit, just we should write which is the true, which one is false. A binomial has 2 terms? Yes, of course. Obviously, any binomial has 2 terms. So, it is true. Binomial means it has 2 terms. Trinomial, 3 terms. Single term, multinomial. Every polynomial is a binomial? Every polynomial is a binomial? No. Because a polynomial is, maybe it is a monomial or it is a multinomial or it is a trinomial. But every polynomial need not be a binomial. So, write fast. A binomial may have degree 3? Of course. Binomial means just we have 2 terms. Either it has degree 3 or degree 2, anything. So, a binomial may have. It is the chance to get the degree 3. So, true. Now, degree of 0 polynomial is E0. Degree of the 0 polynomial is 0. So, it is also, it is false. 0 polynomial is 0 is false. Next, fourth one. The degree of x square minus 2xy plus y square is 2. So, observe here. The first term degree is 2. Second term degree is 1 plus 1, 2. Third term degree is 2. Highest value is 2. So, total degree of this polynomial is 2. So, again, it is true. Last one. Pi r square is monomial. Monomial means it does not have plus symbol or minus symbol in between of the variables. So, there is no plus or minus here. So, it is a single term. So, a single term means it is called as a monomial. Now, coming to the last bit. Give one example each of a monomial or trinomial by using with degree 10. Just we only, we should write the monomial and trinomial. Any one example. But that polynomial has degree 1. For example, monomial means we should not write any plus symbol or minus symbol. So, minus 6. Minus 6 x to the power of 10. There is no plus and minus symbol in between of 6 and x, right? And we should take the degrees till single term, monomial, trinomial. We have three terms. Three terms means we should write two signs. For example, 16 x power 10 minus 8 x to the power of 7 plus 6. Trinomial. Trinomial means we are writing any three terms and write the variables, and we have to write the degrees till like that you have write more two exams for these two. Now from this we are completed exercise 2.1. Now going to the next topic.